Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot with a video that should essentially be the Stomping Blog episode 2 for this week. And it will be the only content for today, and I'm going to explain why. In the Stomping Blog yesterday, you lovely folks at home, you crazy, crazy people who listen to me rant for 30 minutes at a time, will remember I mentioned I got my exam results back yesterday, last night, midnight. Exam results, the idea, 2-1, go to med school, life. Didn't happen. Didn't get a 2-1. Failed. Did fail. Got a 2-2. It's not good enough. It's not what I wanted. Doesn't really get me anywhere. Blah, 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 blah. Thought I'd get that out nice and early. It was a bit of a failure. And that's okay. I've decided it's okay. Now, I'm going to explain why. I did a video last night about coping with disappointment. And it was meant to be scheduled to upload at about an hour's time. And it's currently 7. So it's going to go up about 8 o'clock tonight, GMT. Although we're not in GMT time right now. Tea time. Anyways, so I just deleted that video because it was stupid. We don't have to cope with disappointment. Disappointment's not something to cope with. I've decided. I was listening to a song before, right? I've had a great day. I've had a phenomenal day. Last night was one of the lowest points in my history. I sat there with a 2-2 thinking, I've wasted 3 years of my life. I'm not going to med school. I'm going to have to change what I want to do for the rest of my life. Blah, 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 blah. And it was the best thing that's ever happened to me, I think, possibly. Today's been phenomenal. Do you want to know what I did today, ladies and gentlemen? Today I set up BestInSlot Limited, a limited company where I am the sole director and employee. It's awesome. There's an official company called BestInSlot Limited. How cool is that? Exceptionally. I didn't really want to call it BestInSlot Limited, but I kind of panicked on the spot, so I chose it, but whatever. So I've got a company now. Officially have a company, as bizarre as that sounds. And it's not really going to make a difference to you guys in the slightest. Or me, really. It just means I have to fiddle around more tax stuff. But that's part and parcel. Two things are common. Death and taxes. They are the only absolutes in life, ladies and gentlemen. And happiness, for some of us. For all of us. Everyone gets happiness sometimes. Happiness. Penis. Right. So what I wanted to talk about is, I did this video last night, and it was all, you know what, disappointment to an extent. You know what, I have to use personal examples. Okay, so I'm not going to go to med school. And then it got me thinking, did I want to do another 6 years of education to go be a doctor? Is that really part of my plan in life? Is that really what I was passionate about? And the answer, quite simply, was no. It wasn't. It's not what I dreamt of doing since I was a child. It's not something I really loved and wanted to do. It was the logical choice. And to an extent, this little 2-2 instead of the 2-1 that I really wanted, and I mean, it's not stopped me doing medicine, but it has made me think, you know what, maybe I should look elsewhere. Maybe I should look at doing something I'm truly passionate about. I'm trying to find that thing, you know, because I don't really know what it is. And I think the idea that we should know what we want to do for the rest of our lives at the age of 18, 20, whatever, it's a bit silly, because you're going to live for a long time, ladies and gentlemen. My dad, I keep using him as an example. He's a phenomenal human being. At 34, he just got his law degree. Just got it. Just decided to go and do a law degree whilst he was raising me and my sister. And now he's, you know, got a multi-million pound practice and he's very successful and stuff. And that's like 15 years ago he decided to do that. He found something he loved and he did it. And that's what matters. That's what I want to talk about. Sort of. I don't really know what I want to talk about, but the last video was somewhat depressing and I want to do an optimistic one because I feel disgustingly happy right now, and I shouldn't. I've got no legitimate reason to be this happy, but I am, and I'll tell you why. I don't know what I want to do. I'm looking at law, possibly. Law sounds awesome. Always wanted to do law in the past. It's always been a possibility and a slight passion of mine. I might do travel writing. I might play games for the rest of my life. I might be a commentator and presenter and stuff for game shows. Who knows? The world is wide open, and that's the point. I'm going to spend the next couple of years travelling. I can do that if I want. My flat's pretty much sorted. I've got a limited company. Things are good. And that's the thing. You've got to, we're all going to have disappointments, right? Things are going to suck sometimes. And not in a good way. Things are going to be bad. Not like a sheep either. Just bad, generally. Not bad like that, because I don't know why I did that. I think I'm a little bit on edge. I've not slept in times. Many, many times since sleep has erupted from the bowels of space. Anyways, so. Everyone's going to face disappointment sometimes. We are. You know, you're not always going to get the job you want or the promotion you want or be able to do that little trip you want or get the girl or guy you want, or maybe you're not going to have a baby for the first year you're trying to have a baby. I don't know. Maybe, you know, someone else comes along and has your baby. You don't know. Other people are going to be better at you than at certain things, and you're going to be better than other people at certain things, and that's okay. You've got to learn to face disappointment not as a, oh, I failed. Where? And I'm a bad example, because for what I'm about to say, all I want to say really is, if you find something you're truly passionate about, and I don't think I have yet personally, but if you have something you're truly passionate about, fight for it, you know, really work for it. Because I didn't work for my degree. I didn't, because I'm not passionate about it. I don't enjoy it particularly. It was a means to an end at the end of the day. I got the degree, I'm out of there. I'm done. I'm done with it as a subject. I know it was. Biomedical science was never really a thing for me. But if you find that thing, and I know loads of you are passionate about certain things, a lot of you have told me what you're passionate about, and that's awesome. And you should let me know in the comments, what are you passionate about? What do you want to do with your life? Just give it everything you've got, because at the end of the day, you're not on this earth for that long. Life is beautiful because it's short, essentially, but to the same extent, you've got to enjoy it while you've got it. The sunset is only beautiful because it's fleeting, ladies and gentlemen. If the sunset was perpetual, and then the middle of the day was the equivalent of the sunset, then the middle of the day would be the beautiful lighting. It's beautiful because it's fleeting and unique and rare. It's like a four-leaf clover or a sober Irishman. You know, they don't come along that often. You got to grab them while you can. Don't grab a sober Irishman. You'll die. But other than, I can say that because I'm half Irish. Other than that, just go for it. Just grab life by the goddamn balls, ladies and gentlemen. Just do it. Why not? What's stopping you? I've been thinking about this all day. I was humming along to this song on the train on the way home, and one of the lines that's repeated is just, I came out swinging. And that's what you got to do. You got to come out swinging every time you fuck up, because you will fuck up, and I apologise, this is not a PG-13 video. You're going to fuck up. Everyone's going to fuck up. People make mistakes. People do stupid things. People fail. That's life. And it's not a bad part of life. You can't have the fuck-ups. You can't have the good without the fuck-ups. I'm going to say fuck a lot in this video. Okay, that's just the way it is. I'm going to put a PG-13 warning at the start of this video. No other word. Mess ups just doesn't. It's a fuck up. It's not a mess up. It's a fuck up. I do apologize if you're 12 or have children, or you're just offended in general by swearing. Although I don't know why you'd be offended by swearing, because intrinsically it doesn't mean anything as a word. It's just like super powerful. It doesn't mean anything negative. If you say fuck up, it's not intrinsically offensive in the slightest. It's very confusing for me. Swear words. People worry far too much about swear words. Anyways. I was saying words, and I can't remember what they were. Was it about butter? It's never about butter these days. Ah, the days it used to be about butter. Life was so simple. Yeah, you're going to mess up. You're going to fuck up. And just be annoyed, be pissed, be angry, punch things, cry, do what you have to do. You know, I punched my pillow. I smashed like 3 plates last night. I was raging at myself. I was so disappointed and annoyed. And then I sat back and looked at what I want to do and what I really want to do and the opportunities I've got in front of me, thanks to you guys who watch the channel and subscribe to listen to me rant on whilst jumping around pointlessly on a rock with a torch in my hand, because you all are crazy people, like I keep telling you. And it, you know, I'm going to spend the next couple, the idea is I'm going to spend the next couple of years travelling around the world. Maybe I'll fall in love with some French girl. Maybe she'll break my heart. Who knows? Who cares? It's part of life. The great tapestry, painful, agonizing tapestry of life. And it, you know, we're all lucky intrinsically. A lot of people, yeah, people have shitty lives and things go bad and stuff, but at the end of the day, this planet's incredible and we're all incredibly lucky to be here. And I know I sound like I'm high and I'm a hippie. I promise I'm neither of those things. I've chugged a lot of Relentless, but that's about it. I'm not sure I'm even speaking English at this point in time. I'm going to try to enunciate my words a little bit more. A little bit more. Bit bop. Tip top old chap. How dapper. Anyways. So, what was I saying? Not about butter, again. If you don't remember that joke, that's a joke from like the Skyrim days. There's always this thing about butter, and I don't really know where it came from. I'm assuming that's how Butterbinky got started. I can't believe it's not Butterbinky. Anyways. I just wanted to, I don't know. If you're in school and you're doing a course that you're passionate about and it's leading to a career or profession or just a love that you honestly think is what you want to do for the rest of life, just go and bloody do it. Stop your whining and go bloody do it. There is nothing stopping you. If you are lucky enough to be sitting here listening to me babble on the internet, you are lucky enough to be able to go and do what you want with your life, pretty much. I honestly believe that, bottom of my heart. Go, live your lives, and if you fail, and you will fail sometimes, because people fail. I failed yesterday. You just gotta come out swinging. That's all you gotta do. And it's not easy. Sometimes it's gonna be hard. Sometimes it's gonna be agonizing. You're gonna be heartbroken sometimes. You're gonna cry in a corner. You're gonna punch things. You're gonna punch people. You're gonna get punched. Life's hard, but the good moments make the bad moments so worth it. And honestly, all I can say is I really want to be an example for this, because last night I was dying, and today has been one of the singular best days of my life, probably. So, come out swinging, ladies and gentlemen. Always come out swinging. You're tougher than life. You show life who's boss. You make life your bitch. Sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm going to go. When I tried to record this last night, and I did record this last night, it ranted on for ages, and I don't want to go on too long. I'd love to be good at this kind of little video, you know, these, like, advice pieces that people do, and they're really, like, deep and emotional about life, and they can wax lyrical for days about the splendours of life, and it's just not something I can do. I can wax lyrical for ages, but it's all crap. So, I don't know. It just felt necessary. It feels necessary. I want you, everyone, man up, alright? Or woman up. No, just man up. If you're a woman, man up. Manning in this situation is not a gender thing, it's just a... Show life who's boss, yeah? Come out swinging, ladies and gentlemen. Come out swinging.